My name is Jane Kennedy. I'm Director of Teaching School at St John Bosco Arts College in Croxton, Liverpool.
Cool. So what were your motivations behind getting involved with the China Sister School programme?
Variety of things. I've always believed that education is at the heart of making sure young people have got the best possible life chances, and as Director of a Teaching School, it's important that we've got teachers that are equipped to facilitate the education of their young people. But obviously the world is a much broader space than just the classroom. So the opportunity was first flagged to teaching schools with the introduction of the government announcement for the Mandarin Expansion Programme, and £10 million sounds like a lot of money, and is a huge incentive to starting investigating and exploring further. Obviously, that led us to work with Access China UK, and if I say the rest is history, it's been an interesting journey. It's not been an easy journey trying to convince certain members of the leadership team that this was something that was valuable and was worth doing, when we've got Ofsted knocking on our door and different constraints within our own financial budgets, the context of the school, etc. But actually, bringing these seven students over as part of an ambassadors programme that has been facilitated by Access China UK, it's been an amazing experience.
Cool. So, top three things from your point of view from this idea.
The warmth and the hospitality, the way that students on both sides have actually embraced the opportunities, and the fact that children are children the world over, and it doesn't matter whether they speak different languages or they've got different cultures, actually seeing them, living in a room together, as we saw last night, where the adults are nearby but not constantly looking over their shoulder, and actually none of that matters. They're global citizens, and they will make their way if they're given the opportunities. Second thing has been watching the magic on the girls' faces from the delegation that we've brought over. The warmth that they've experienced, the friendships that have been rekindled, and the new ones that have been made, and now the fact that they want to be lead ambassadors to make sure that this programme lives and breathes back in our own school setting. And the third thing, I suppose, has been converting the hearts and minds of their teacher, and the fact now that, having experienced it for himself, he knows that the children are in safe hands, and actually he will be the one that will empower other leaders within the school to come and experience it for themselves.
Fantastic. And top three things from the student's point of view, which I think they've gained from the experience.
I think the students have gained a greater understanding of the similarities and differences between school life and life generally in both cultures. I think the enormity of their journey personally towards that greater sense of independence, being 6,000 miles away from home, with some of them for the very, very first time, that's been huge for them. And you know, listening to some of them now saying, I'd like to come back to China, I want to come and study in China, I'd like to take Mandarin, why do we have to do Spanish, why can't we? It's all of those questions. I think as well it's been good from their perspective, as is always the case, that they can actually see their teachers in a different light. And when their teachers get stuck in and are embracing it too, there's no reason for them to be afraid that they can't do it.
Right, hello, my name is Darren Gidman. I'm the head teacher at St John Bosco Arts College. I first learned about this particular programme through work with Access China. One of the exciting parts about this programme is the fact that it allows students to really develop their understanding of different cultures. We brought along seven students from Liverpool, and I suppose in many ways certainly expanded our horizons, and I include the staff as well.
Awesome. So, your top three highlights from the trip?
I suppose my highlights from this particular trip, first of all, are actually developing a further understanding of the Chinese culture, really understanding how Chinese families work so closely together to support one another, whether that's through support them through school, support them, I suppose, in meal times as well, which is quite an interesting feature of Chinese life. And I suppose my third highlight of this trip is the relationships, say the relationship between the two schools and also the relationships between the staff and the students as well at all levels.
Cool. So what do you think, feedback from students, what do you think from your perspective has been the most, again, top three, most important things for specifically the students?
From the students' point of view, I felt that the students wanted longer here. They certainly had started to develop relationships and were exchanging telephone numbers amongst other things. And I suppose that they wanted to develop their communication with students at Wenzhou Foreign Language School. I suppose when the return trip happens in July, those relationships will be further strengthened. So I suppose from the students' point of view, it's developing perhaps lifelong friendships.
Awesome. And then the final point is, if you had a group of head teachers sitting on the fence, they didn't really know, they heard about it, they thought, okay, China's kind of interesting, but has some concerns, not quite sure if we're ready for it, what would you say to a group of people who are on the fence?
I suppose one of the things that I would say to people is that I had reservations before coming along on this journey, and those doubts in my mind have certainly been taken away by actually visiting the country, by seeing the organisation that sits behind Access China, that sits behind the trip. As I've said before, my doubts have evaporated over time. Certainly enjoying it. Certainly something I think that all schools should get involved in, so that all students have the opportunity to develop links, I suppose, right across the world, but in particular in China.
What program are you guys on at the moment?
We're on a student exchange trip in China with our sister school.
Cool. So, what are your top three favourite things you found?
Is I had a chance to learn how to play tennis, eating a lot of like different foods, and chance to learn some Mandarin.
Cool, what are you saying?
My top three favourite things are going to the island, going to the school and meeting new people.
Cool.
Yeah, my top three favourite things are meeting some new Chinese friends, because not many people could say they've got Chinese friends, can't they? Going to China at 13, not many people can do that.
Yeah.
And then just going away with my friends.
Very good.
What are you about? My top three things. Playing tennis, coming to the school, and going to the museum. And should go for it. It's a really nice place.
Really warm.
You get bragging rights.
You don't even say I've been to China.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Rosie. I'm from St. John Bosco. My top three things are the island, the school, and the people in the school. My top three things are when we first came and the people in the school were like, kept coming over to us and we were really happy to see us. And yesterday when we had lunch with the Chinese people and going to the island.
My top three things are when we had the meal yesterday with the Chinese people, it was really cool. And then when we went to the island.
There's not many people our age in England, I can say. Like teenagers, I've been to China with like 2 years.
Plus the people here.